So with that said, let's get to the final story. Not the final story,
thrust,
the final boss.
Increasing engine output at maximum. Course plotted. Gate open. Lifting off.
The egg carrier seemed really small in that cutscene.
Why is this happening? No! Playtime's over.
Stop dancing, Eggman.
Sonic.
This ship is about to crash. Too bad, Eggman.
So having a tantrum.
I'm not finished yet. You keep getting in my way, you pesky little hedgehog. Very well. I'll take you out myself.
So it turns out that the aquatic base is located within Kingdom Valley. As you saw, the water rises there. But it is now time for the final boss of Sonic's story. This is the Egg Wyvern. And those of you who have played Sonic Adventure, well, then this boss seems very familiar. What we are essentially dealing with here is the Egg Viper. I recommend not picking up all these rings. Eggman will simply circle around Sonic. He'll try and... he has a bunch of attacks. See this one? Step away from those things. He'll try and fire lasers. They create large explosions, but the hitboxes for them are tiny. What you need to wait for is for Eggman to say, "That! Here I come, Sonic!" When he charges, homing attack, grab a hold of the antenna, just like the Egg Cerberus. And now what you need to do is you need to steer it into these pieces of debris, but when they're there, where they are, is luck, basically. Right, I actually managed to hit that, I'm surprised. There will be times where the debris can end up interrupting Sonic in the jump, and that can kill you. That has happened to me at least once, it's really annoying. But again, the Egg Wyvern's music. My god, I love this music so much. I'm sorry I keep gushing over it, but I can't help it. This is one of the best soundtracks ever. Yeah, Eggman's like a little kid when he does some of these moves. Yeah, the boss is different enough from the Egg Viper, but it is still a bit too similar. The main difference being is that we don't have any get a load of this! Thank God. You can make steering this thing a little bit easier by using the red gem, but it doesn't help that much. Okay. I always get nervous when that happens. Yeah, the egg carrier looks a lot smaller in that cutscene. Where Sonic jumps on it, but now this thing, now it looks like a battleship. But one of the deadliest attacks in this game is when these lasers, or whatever they are, they come out of the egg carrier. I can never tell where they're coming from. So, I will get hit by them, I can assure you. These things. They come from various parts of the ship. I can never tell where they're going to appear from. You know, Eggman, you could just destroy the remainder of these platforms. Just like during the battle in the Egg Viper, he never gets the idea to destroy all of the platforms. He only destroys half of them. You use the red gems to make jumping on it a bit easier. Okay, where are these bits of debris? I need a bit of debris. You do have quite a lot of time on the Egg Wyvern. I nearly said Viper, see what I mean? Sometimes it's just luck based on where the debris actually is. Are you? Sounds like a robot carnival. It's like, this is only the beginning. Hey, he's like a little kid. He's having fun in this thing. Oh, so now he can run into the debris and nothing happens. See, I completely forgot about that. It only came from one side of the ship, Pat. Again, that thing is going to create a massive explosion, and I'm perfectly fine. See, that's the same line. Oh! That's the second time that's happened to me now. I hate it when that happens. I gotta do the whole boss fight again. Ugh, cut! See if you can make it through here, Sonic! It's the exact same line. Minus, like, two words. But anyway. Finally back. The homing attack was being a bit decisive. I actually homing attacked him when he charged at me. But instead of grabbing a hold of the antenna, Sonic decided he didn't want to do anything anymore. So he just stopped. But he didn't stop. He air dashed into the egg wyvern and got hurt. But yeah, apparently you can run over these little fence things. That happened to me when I was testing this as well. That was annoying. Yeah, just like the egg viper. Let me attack on the blasters, and you can then get to Eggman. Again, Eggman. What you have to do is destroy the remaining platforms. But no, because Eggman has an apparent IQ of 300 that he only has because he doesn't know how to count to 300, he doesn't get that idea. Obviously, the attack right there, that becomes a lot harder to avoid when there's less platforms. And at the moment. That is also harder to avoid. I don't know if it's a set pattern to how he destroys the platforms, or if he just destroys them if he destroys them in a set order, if it's just random, which ones. I think it's the middle one is always the one that stays there. So, what's Eggman now gonna do? Well, it's simple. There are four platforms left. It only makes sense that Eggman destroys them all, right? There's three platforms left. But no, he decides to let this one platform stay here. I don't even know where this platform is coming from. Why is this platform here? But no, he doesn't get the idea, so destroy this one platform. So what's he going to do? Simple, he's going to try the charge maneuver again. So now, there's no antenna, just homing attack him. Don't worry about falling down. And that's it, we did it. We defeated the Egg Wyvern. Now, best part of the fight, right? Death animation was that? I don't even think you can call that an animation. He just remains in that position throughout the whole thing, even when he hits that bit of debris. Ugh. You can never take Eggman seriously, and you definitely can't do it after a death animation like that. But anyway, that's it! We did it! That is the ending of Sonic Story! We've done it! We've done the best part of the game. Wonderful. Sadly, that's still not quite enough rings to go and get the yellow gem, but that'll all be in good time. I'll get that later. It's not like I'm missing much with it. Music from Sonic Episode is now available in the order room. Yay! Sonic Episode is now available in the theater room. You can view all of the cutscenes. Yay! Yes, I do want to save.
Sonic!
Aren't you worried?
If you have time to worry, then none, right?
When I worry about not getting homework done on time, I don't run. What good's that gonna do? That's not gonna get it done. What's something trying to grab?
nice smile.
His eyes are still coming off of his face. But that laugh, though, that laugh. That song? I think that's a pretty good song. That was originally made for Sonic 2. It's called Sweet Dreams. The version that was heard in Sonic 2 ended up just being an instrumental version. I don't know if that was a limitation to the Mega Drive or anything, but all we got was an instrumental version. There was a version with lyrics, and it ended up being remixed for this game. A lot of people don't like it. I actually really like that song. The version, what we're hearing right now is His World, but we'll get more into that later. We can't actually hear the full song in any of these credits. So, that is the end of Sonic Story. Personally, I really like playing through Sonic Story. Again, it's when I say that I like the game, when I say I like playing with Sonic, I'm talking about the action stages. You know, the boss fights aren't very interesting, the town missions are dreadful. But when it comes to just playing through the town missions, repetitiveness with Wave Ocean aside, I do think that I do get a lot of enjoyment out of playing as Sonic. I can say the same with Shadow, I can't really say the same with Silver. But I can say that with Sonic and Shadow, just simply playing through their stages is a lot of fun. That is what I'm saying. Sonic 06 is not a good game, but it can be a fun one. That is the main point I'm trying to get out here. There are a number of things I will defend, there are another things I won't dare to defend, because you can't defend them. This game has a lot of problems. We've seen a number of them. You know, I was suffering with all sorts of issues with the gravity and tropical jungle. The issues with the camera, many of them, particularly in the boss fights. Times where I get hurt, when I really shouldn't get hurt. I'm going to be showcasing some of those in some of these videos. You've probably already seen them but when I edit them in. So I had to do a couple of things twice, particularly Wave Ocean with Tails, and I ended up having a much easier time than the Trials of Soliana. And then I had to do Kingdom Valley twice. That wasn't the game's fault, that was my fault. But that is the end of Sonic Story. That is the end of the best part of Sonic 06, sadly. But, you know, not to say that the rest of the game is absolutely horrible. I already said, I like playing with Shadow. It's Silver that I don't really get any enjoyment out of. So, for the sake of that, you know, get Silver out of the way, I'm going to do Silver next. Just to get it out of the way, so that I can then have a better time playing with Shadow. Although, that won't help too much considering the fact that I am playing hard mode. I am playing very hard mode. I am playing boss attack. I'm doing everything in this game, folks. The only thing I'm not doing, probably, will be the silver medals. I'm not going for all the S ranks, obviously. And that's the song we just heard, Sweet Dreams. It's also, Sweet Dream is the one we heard. The game also includes the Japanese version for some reason, which is no sweet, sweet, sweet. It's the exact same thing, only, you know, I can't understand a word that's being said. Oh, that song looks familiar. We'll be hearing all these songs later on, including his world, don't worry. But that is the end. I've said that a number of times already, I'm dawdling now. That is the end of Sonic Story. Next time we meet up, for Sonic the Hedgehog 2006, we will be doing Silver Story. God help me. This is a long video. See you guys next time.